Yeah, obviously it's good to be back home and after a long, long week. But that's what team building's all about too. You know, we put ourselves in some tough situations, three games in a row on the road. And really at the end of the day, to put ourselves in position to win each and every one of those games, I was really, really proud of our guys. Obviously going in a little bit shorthanded, the chemistry that our team had, the connectivity that we grew throughout the week was pretty special, and to be able to get one last night was certainly a feel good deal and a step in the right direction, but also looking forward to being at Frost for two big games, obviously North Dakota on Thursday and North Dakota State on Saturday. So we're excited to be home.
Tom, if you want to get us going.
And Hendo, I mean, basically getting it done with five guys right now, it's good to win a game that way, but it's hard to win a game that way. And what's it going to be like going forward?
Yeah, you know, obviously we have to be creative when you're a little bit shorthanded. But we're certainly hopeful that, you know, Charlie and Alex are back sooner than later. Both of them are kind of on a, you know, day-to-day basis. But they're working hard, and we're excited to, you know, continue to grow as a team. But hopefully here in a short amount of time, get some guys back too.
All right. And you fully expect Alex back? Can you speak to that situation, his absence at all?
Yeah, you know, he's dealing with some personal issues. And like I said, Tom, it's really a situation that we're dealing with just day to day. And being back home is certainly helpful. And we're certainly hopeful in the short term. There's no doubt.
All right. And Zeke has stepped up. Willie Kyle has stepped up as well. And Mimsy, I mean, you're getting those contributions you need from those five guys for the most part, aren't you?
Yeah, you know, obviously what they're giving us is incredible, and they're obviously playing maybe a few more minutes than we like, and you know that did affect us a little bit, especially earlier in the week. You know, got wore out down, you know, late in the game situations, and our mental capacity probably wasn't where it needed to be, and when you can get a rest and you can get a breath, you know, and it can be a short one. Those are just so important. And so we're continuing to work on that. Obviously, we played a little bit of zone last night, and that was able to give our guys maybe just a little bit of a breather as well. And certainly was a big foul trouble was part of that too. But those guys, like you said, Tom, and add Matt Dentlinger to that mix, they're stepping up in a huge way.
Michael?
Yeah. Losing those big leads the past couple games, is that fatigue? You mentioned obviously lack of personnel, but is that fatigue for the free throws too?
Well, I don't know about that, Michael. I think that's just conference play, to be honest with you, and being on the road too. I mean, obviously the one at Western Illinois stings a little bit, you know, obviously because we lost, number one. But, you know, they're playing well, and you got to give the other team credit at times. Now, I do feel like instead of fatigue at Western Illinois, I think it was just a little bit more of us losing a little bit of focus and relaxing just a little bit, you know, because we played so well in that first half, and we just lost our edge. And then it's hard to get it back when a team is playing the way that they are, and especially Mastner. I mean, all their guys made plays, but some of the shots that he made were really, really tough, and that just that momentum was contagious for their whole squad. And then, you know, last night it was you know more of the case of just, you know, it wasn't a huge lead. It was just more, you know, they were physical. They're a good basketball team, and we were able to, you know, come together, be connected, and really make some toughness plays that kept us in the game there when it wasn't going our way for a little bit in the second half, and we were able to respond.
Obviously, you were able to put enough things together to get the win yesterday, but how do you mend that going forward so that you don't have to even be in those situations?
Well, you know, our guys are getting better. I mean, you know, you look at, you know, Matthew Moores, you look at You know, Tanner Tislaw, you look at Broden Lean. It's not like they're not – I mean, I thought Broden played his best 10 minutes of the season last night. You know, he scored a couple baskets. He rebounded well in a game that rebounding was going to be really, really important, you know. And Matthew Morris, I thought, looked as comfortable, you know, on the perimeter as he has, you know, all season last night. Now, he didn't maybe necessarily score it, but he was comfortable. He was making a few plays. He was relaxed, and that's what we need. And that takes a little time. That, I mean, he was kind of playing at the four for us for the most part. Now, with where we're at with some injuries and things like that, he's had to play on the perimeter a little bit more. And so he's just getting more comfortable. And so, you know, I know we talked maybe about five guys, but – even though the minutes for Tanner, even though the minutes for Broden, even though the minutes for Matthew may not be as large as the other ones, they're still helping us. You know, we had a chance to win every single game we played now. Don't get it twisted. Now, did we? No. But we got to continue to put ourselves in a situation where we have a chance to win.
What did you make of that final play yesterday? Were you trying to guard the catch and shoot on the perimeter and they were trying to catch you sleeping at all? Or is it like what was, from your perspective?
With that last tip in?
Yeah.
I mean, it was a hard shot. I mean, he's a pretty good athlete, you know, and we wanted something more on the perimeter, and he's a really good athlete. We got a little bit mixed in up going for the screen, and Zeke got a little bit out of position, but we came back and challenged the play, and now he was a little higher than the rest of us, but got the shot off, but still a really, really hard shot. We had William on the ball, and you know, that's kind of the situation. Hey, do you put him on the ball or do you put him at the rim? You know, that's, you know, a 50-50, and he didn't tip the ball, so maybe you can say it didn't work, but he also didn't make the shot, so maybe you can say it worked.
Thank you.
Andrew?
With last night's win, you guys moved into a tie for second place in the conference. Is that something you guys pay attention to down the stretch here, or you just kind of let that play out?
Well, you know how we look at things, Andrew. We look at things a game at a time, and all of our focus is on North Dakota. Now, we also understand that the two seed is a really big advantage when it comes to the Summit League tournament. So it's something that we need to look at, but we're in a situation where we're trying to develop young people to help us moving forward, especially those, you know, four out of the seven guys we're playing right now are freshmen. So to continue to get those guys experiences and continue to try to find situations where they can be really, really impactful. And then also getting Alex and Charlie back into the mix, you know, hopefully sooner rather than later, is really what our focus is on. Because it, and I know Zim asked this question last week, hey, this season maybe more than others, are you really preparing for the Summit League tournament? It's a fair question because we hope to be at full strength at the Summit League tournament time, and we're not right now. But there's still a process of we're trying to win every game we play. There's still a process of, hey, let's continue to get these young guys better and better every time we step on the floor.
Talked about, you know, how excited you are for Charlie to come back. What, other than depth, you know, what does he bring back to this team?
Well, I mean, he was shooting 44% from the three-point line. He's one of the best defenders in our league on the perimeter. He's tougher than heck. He's a great chemistry guy. All of his teammates love him. And that's in depth as well is something that, like you said, is also really, really valuable. How he impacts our team is pretty, you know, immeasurable.
Thanks.
Zim?
Hey, you guys have asked most of the good questions, but I just wanted to ask a little bit about North Dakota and North Dakota State, just what you see in them. And, you know, in particular, the Bison, they look a little bit like they're kind of similar to you guys this year, and just that they got off to a rough start. Seemed like they're sort of figuring themselves out a little bit, but a lot like you guys, you know, they're always going to be there at the end, and it's always a battle when you guys play each other.
Yeah, I mean, that game's on Saturday, you know, so it's not, I haven't looked at them too much, but to the game against NDSU, I think we all know what we're going to get, Zim. I mean, you're right. You know, they have a lot of new kids. They're playing young kids as well and got a couple staples in their program that have been, you know, there for a while that understand what it takes to win. Like very similar to us, like you said, Zim, and you know, the Nelson kid is playing at a really, really high level, scoring the basketball, shooting it from the perimeter a little bit better. You know, he's just so long and impacts the game in a lot of ways. So we know what that's going to be like on Saturday, and I'm sure we'll have a great environment. But North Dakota's playing better too. You know, they made 18 threes the other day against Kansas City at home and won. You know, they shot it very, very well against North Dakota State last week. And they're playing a lot more free. You know, they're playing a lot faster. They're playing some different guys that really space the floor, and they can shoot it a lot from a lot more positions than they did maybe when we were playing them before. So we'll have our hands full on Thursday. You know, we got to really do a great job of guarding the arc. Their big kid inside's playing well too. So we got a big challenging weekend ahead. But I'll also say we're excited to be in Frost Arena too.